Welcome back. This presentation deals with the second type of associative learning, that is operant conditioning. Operant conditioning is otherwise termed as selective learning or trial and error learning or instrumental learning. The term itself says that trial and error. So the learning is made possible by repeated trials, making errors, correcting it, and then coming into a complete concrete pattern. So here what happens, it is actually usually found in higher vertebrates. And in this type of learning, the animal learns after several trials and errors. And most of the complex behaviors of higher animals result from this kind of selective learning. This particular concept was put forward or brought forward by Skinner, who had conducted many experiments on operant conditioning. This trial and error is common among higher animals, and obviously through dealing with circumstances and conditions and social situations in the surroundings, we learn, isn't it? So that is actually trial and error. Okay, simple way is we learn that when we touch a hot object, we get burnt, isn't it? So that kind of a behavior, development of a behavior, that is, we actually try not to touch the hot object with a bare hand. So that is a kind of learning. There's a trial and error, like learning to write neatly, isn't it? Then learning musical instruments, to play the musical instruments, then what, even bicycling. So all these coordinated activities we learn through trial and error. Okay, at the first instance or in the first stage itself, we may not learn proper or execute the behavior in the complete way. But through trial and error, we correct it, we modify it, we actually groom it to the best possible way. So that kind of a learning is actually the operant conditioning or the learned behavior. This kind of a learned behavior. As said, it was termed and it was developed by Skinner. And he had conducted experiments on rats. Okay. Before we go into the experiment he had conducted, we'll just see the different features of this particular method. As said, it is actually found in higher animals, those animals who are prone to make mistakes in dealing with the situations and conditions in the society or in the environment. So it is a behavior that is guided by its consequences. That is, what is the result obtained. So here what we can see that the trial type of behavior produces responses that could have positive or negative results. So the positive result is what we have termed as rewards, and negative result is what we have termed as punishment. Okay. So the positive outcome of a response, actually the reward, actually it enhances the particular behavior or response, and the negative outcome decreases the frequency of the response. So at the same time, learning efficiency increases with the repetition of trial activities. So how many times we try out that particular what you call behavior, we are going to increase the efficiency. We are going to improve the efficiency. Okay, in trial and error learning, an animal learns to eliminate a behavior that produces no reward, or it produces a negative effect, which we have referred as a punishment. Okay, and also it through this trial and error learning, the animal learns to repeat a behavior which produces a positive effect. And as already said, many of the coordinated activities or behavior put up in higher organisms or higher vertebrates especially are developed through trial and error learning. Now with regard to the okay, this is what we have already said, that the operant conditioning or the what you call the trial and error method, it goes through the reinforcement and punishment. Okay, so reinforcement, if it is positive, obviously what happens is behavior increases. The animal do have the tendency to repeat that particular behavior. Okay, in the case of negative reinforcement, the behavior obviously increases. For example, what happens is if a child is told to do something, and after performing that particular behavior, if the child is given chocolate. That is a positive reinforcement. So what happens is the child do have a tendency to repeat that particular behavior. Okay, that is one way of making sure that the child performs a particular behavior. Right? There is another way. And just imagine, if you are told that unless you complete your homework, you are not going to get the chance to watch a particular movie. Okay, just imagine, or watch the TV. Okay, so what happens over here? The person does the homework. Okay, the behavior is performed, that is doing the homework. Okay, but what happens? The person is not getting a reward. Instead, the stimulus is removed. What is it? Watching TV. Okay, that is a kind of a reinforcement. Okay, that is being taken away. Okay, so that is a negative reinforcement, but still the child performs the behavior. Okay, and there is a tendency of the child to perform the behavior repeatedly and more efficient way so that the child gets the opportunity to watch the TV. Okay, so positive reinforcement means a result, a reward is given, for example, and negative reinforcement means there is no reward, but the person is made to do the particular behavior so that the other kind of a stimulus is given. I hope the connection is clear. Now, operant conditioning also develops through punishment. Okay, now punishment here, positive punishment, that is the person is actually tasked. So when a person is punished for a particular behavior, the frequency of the particular behavior to be performed decreases. For example, if a child does something and the child is getting punished for that particular behavior, obviously the child next time, what happens is the child tries to avoid performing that particular behavior, isn't it? That is a positive punishment. The behavior decreases. Another is obviously negative. Okay, so again, if a particular behavior is done, okay, you are not going to get the video game. Okay. So that kind of a behavior, that is actually behavior decrease. Okay, so if you are doing this particular, if you are showing this kind of an attitude, you are not going to get the video game. So what happens? The child tries to avoid performing that kind of an attitude. Okay, and the child can get the video game. So that is a punishment, a negative punishment through which the behavior, that kind of behavior can be decreased. I hope it is clear. Okay, it's a reward and punishment. So here, this was the experiment conducted by Skinner, and hence it is known as a Skinner box. And the major contributions in this particular aspect of learning was given by Skinner as well as Thorndike. And Skinner conducted experiments using rats, and Skinner improvised a device with a kind of slot machine arrangement, and this is the box, and it is referred as a Skinner box. You can see here it is Skinner box. And when a starved rat, here you can see, was put in a Skinner box, the rat randomly moves about in search of food. And when it accidentally, you can see here lever, when it accidentally presses the lever, what happens is the food is derived. Okay, here you can see there are food pellets, and when the lever is pressed, the food gets delivered through here. So actually what happened is when it was moving about here, it accidentally pressed onto the lever, isn't it? So it got the food. Now what happens is the rat tries to repeat that. Okay, so when it accidentally pressed the lever, the slot was opened and food was delivered, the food pellet was delivered. Though the rat did not learn anything from this initially, but by repeated trials it learned that lever pressing is associated with food reward. So then what happens, whenever it is hungry, it will go near the lever, presses the lever, and then get the food. Okay, that kind of a learning happens through trial and error. Thus, an instrumental conditioned responses here it is established. Because the reinforcement can be negative, the animal's learning to escape a noxious stimulus is also instrumental. For example, here there are other electric grid, it is to provide the shock. Okay, it's the speaker, it gives off the this one, the sound. So all those are negative stimulus. The only positive, negative response, the only positive reinforcement is once the liver is pressed, it gives the food. Okay. So here you can see the food in this particular experiment, the liver is actually a conditioned stimulus, and the pressing of the liver, it is actually the conditioned response. The food is the unconditioned stimulus, and eating of the food is the unconditioned response. Okay. So I hope it is clear, and I'll be like sharing the reference books or the reference content as well along with this video. Then I also shared a few of the videos which shows how Pavlov has conducted the experiments and how the Skinner experiment had been conducted. And please watch those footages to learn more. Thank you.